As we mentioned, the state legislature is working towards sending an illegal immigration measure to the ballot. The proposal, called the Secure the Border Act, would make it a state crime to cross the border illegally, empowering state and local police to enforce federal immigration law. And for more on this, we welcome Jim Small of the Arizona Mirror. Jim, good to see you. This is a strike everything amendment. Am I wrong? First of all, what does that mean?
Basically, what it means is there's an existing bill and they're going to erase everything that's in the bill and replace it with brand new legislation. This is the product of negotiation between House Republicans and Senate Republicans, particularly their leaders. There had been, I think, broad consensus that they needed to do something about illegal immigration and trying to put something forward. Some bills earlier had gotten vetoed by the governor, I think, as you mentioned earlier. There had been some disagreement about maybe the best path forward after that veto had happened. The result is this bill that the Senate is taking up right now.
And this, again, would bypass a governor's veto because you go to the ballot and she doesn't have any say in that. Is it much different than the bill that it sounds like? It's awfully similar, but are there some differences?
It is very similar. It includes pretty much the bill that was vetoed earlier this year, and that legislation was copied off of Texas's what's called SB4, which Texas passed, I think, late last year or the very beginning of this year, that went kind of went into effect in the springtime. And this also includes a couple of other components, some added-on stuff, particularly aimed at benefits, who can access benefits, public benefits. It's obviously, again, it's going directly to the ballot instead of the governor's desk. The governor's already said she has rejected it once. She would reject it again. Does not think that this is a solution that will actually work to do what Republicans say they want to do.
And I want to get to the governor's response and Democratic response in a second here. But as far as what this calls for, again, local law enforcement can arrest and seek deportation, huh?
Yeah, and it would ostensibly kind of create a state. You know, the state would be able to deport people, which is something that right now is obviously only handled by the federal government. Federal law enforcement officers enforce immigration law. There's a federal court system, an immigration court system that does all of this. The federal government handles all of the deportations. This would essentially let the state, the idea is to let the state do it, with the idea being that the federal government isn't doing enough, isn't doing it fast enough. And so the states need to step up and do this.
Well, and that's you mentioned it was modeled after the Texas law. That's a big reason the Texas law is in the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals right now, and that you're calling for state enforcement of federal immigration laws. I'm trying to figure this out. This can't take effect unless that Texas law is cleared, correct?
Correct. Right now, that Texas law is on hold in appeals. Part of the appeal had made it up to the Supreme Court and gotten kicked back down. The law had gone into effect briefly, and then a judge jumped in and said, "No, we're gonna issue a stay until this thing gets resolved, until the legal battle's over." But this is something that right now, if you look at the Supreme Court's rulings in the past, that right now this would be something that I think is pretty blatantly unconstitutional, right? But the idea is to challenge the Supreme Court's ruling on Arizona's Senate Bill 1070 from more than a decade ago, to essentially get the Supreme Court to reconsider that. I think proponents of it, Republicans, look at it and say, look, the Supreme Court is 6-3, conservatives. They've overturned precedent very recently, obviously Roe v. Wade, a major one, but there's been a number of other precedents that they have been willing to overturn, and they think that this is the best shot that they have to essentially get the court to rethink its logic in terms of who gets to enforce immigration law.
And indeed, SB 1070 is big here because that was a model for the Texas law. Now you got it in court, and if Texas loses, I mean, this thing is going to go to the Supreme Court, and we could see much of what was blocked by the court in terms of SB 1070 revived. That's a big deal around here.
It is. It definitely, that is a possibility. If they're able to convince the Supreme Court to overturn that precedent and to issue new rules and a new view as to what's legal and what's not for states to do when it comes to enforcing immigration law, and particularly federal law, then yeah, absolutely, it could be a game changer.
Yeah, and the governor, as you mentioned, the governor not impressed that it's not going to change anything. If she had a chance to veto, she would. What were some of the other responses by Democrats?
Yeah, I think Democrats are really looking at this and saying that, look, this is more xenophobia from Republicans. This is more, anti-immigrant rhetoric. This is aimed at trying to boost turnout in the 2024 election, to put this on the ballot. Republicans, I've heard some Democrats that have complained that Republicans are looking for something to counter what's expected to be a surge in in Democratic support because of the abortion constitutional amendment, the initiative there. And generally, I think that there's a lot of looking back and saying, look, we've already been through this in 2010 after Senate Bill 1070. We saw what the fallout was. It was a huge economic fallout in Arizona. There were lots of companies that said, we're not going to do business here. We're going to leave. We're not going to bring our huge conventions here. And obviously, you know, Arizona's economy, particularly in the wintertime, really depends, you know, and is built in a lot of ways on people coming here and on tourism. And so, you know, there were lots of studies done in the wake of 1070 that showed millions of dollars of potential revenue that were taken away or that skipped the state. And you know, there's some calls that, you know, this is going to do the same thing all over again.
Yeah, and more recent studies have shown that maybe it wasn't as big an impact as some folks had originally thought. And so you have competing studies there showing competing things. But I also noticed that the bill, is this circumventing the Attorney General? The Attorney General obviously is going to defend what she wants to defend and kind of leave alone what she would probably leave something like this alone in terms of defense. And so in the bill, lawmakers can defend themselves? How's that work?
Yes, and we've seen this in the past where things have been, you know, written to allow or the legislature's rules allow the leader, the Speaker of the House and the President of the Senate to intervene in litigation. And certainly there have been a number of cases recently where the Republican legislative leaders have intervened to defend a law that Democrats like Chris Mays doesn't want to defend. This one has the peculiar language in it that would allow the minority leaders in both chambers to also do the same thing, which I think it's hard not to read that as a hedge, a Republican mm-hmm. hedge against the fact that there is a, you know, growing possibility that they might lose control of the state legislature for the first time in decades.
Yeah, it would be hard to read anything else into that because that's so unusual. And to that point, and you referred to this earlier, and we're kind of running out of time, but does this move and what's happening in Texas and a possible Supreme Court decision, everything, does this move immigration back ahead of abortion? Because I ask political consultants all the time and they can't figure if it's either immigration or abortion come November. This probably shoves immigration a little ahead, doesn't it?
Well, it definitely puts it back in kind of the more in the conversation about what's actually happening, right? Like this is, you know, something that we've seen Republican candidates, you know, as campaigns have started to get going, immigration has been a recurring theme. The economy's been a recurring theme, you know, on the Democratic side. I mean, I think reproductive rights are a recurring theme, education, healthcare, things like that. So right now, both parties are kind of speaking to their primary voters. And, you know, I think we're going to see some of those conversations shift once we get past that July 30th primary and everyone starts to look to the general. I don't think that there's any doubt, though, that, you know, given where things are at right now, where voters are at right now, that immigration is going to continue to be a major force in the election.
Yeah, and real quick, this will likely pass, what, next Wednesday, next time they meet?
That's the expectation, yeah. That it will pass with Republican support and Democratic opposition.
Gotcha. Jim Small, Arizona Mirror. Good to see you. Thanks for joining us.